Let us discuss the next problem in the 11.1. In the 11.1, the sixth problem is that in triangle ABC and triangle XYZ, angle A is equal to angle X. All acute angles. Here we have taken ABC is a right angle triangle and also XYZ is a right angle triangle. We have mentioned angle A and angle X. These two are the acute angles, and in the given question he has given that cos A is equal to cos X. So cos A is equal to cos X, which is been given, we wrote in the bracket. So cos A, what is the definition of cos? Adjacent side by hypotenuse. So for this angle, what is the adjacent side?
AB
is the adjacent side and AC is the hypotenuse. So we wrote cos A as AB by AC. And cos X, for this angle X, what is the adjacent side? XY is the adjacent side and XZ is the opposite, hypotenuse. So XY by XZ. But we have taken that let AB by AC is equals to XY by ZZ is equals to K, we are taking. AB by AC is equals to XY by XZ is equals to K. So this means AB by AC is equals to K and also XY by XZ is equals to K. With this, AB is equals to K into AC, can be right? XY is equals to K into XZ, can be right? Okay? Now, taking the ratio of sides BC and YZ. Taking the ratio of sides BC and YZ. So, here BC by YZ is equals to BC by YZ is equals to. So, let us see here. Using Pythagoras theorem, if you wanted to find the value of BC, actually using Pythagoras theorem, what? AC square is equal to BC square plus AB square, isn't it or not? So with this, BC square is equal to AC square minus AB square. Isn't it? So with this, BC is equal to what? Under root of AC square minus AB square. Can you get it? Using Pythagoras theorem, this AC square is equal to AB square plus BC square. So BC is equal to under root of AC square minus AB square. Like the same way for this, YZ is equal to what? Under root of XZ square minus XY square. So, here we have taken the ratio between BC and YZ. Ratio between BC and YZ. But here what we got, BC is equal to how much?
Yes.
Under root of AC square minus AB square. By this, BC is equal to under root of AC square minus AB square divided by, what is YZ here? Under root of XZ square minus XY square. XZ square minus XY square. But you see here, AB by AC is equal to K, means AB is equal to what we got?
AC.
K into AC. This value, if we substituted this value in this, what we will get? Under root of AC square minus K into AC whole square divided by under root of xz square minus, instead of xy square, k into xz whole square. Can we write? Next step, if we see the next step, this will be under root of ac square minus k square into ac square divided by under root of xz square minus k square into xz square. K square into xz square. So here you see, if we are taking ac square as common, here ac square is there, here also ac square is there. If we are taking ac square as common, we will get 1 minus k square divided by, in this, if we are taking xz square as common, 1 minus k square. So here 1 minus k square, 1 minus k square will be get cancelled. So finally what we are getting here, under root of ac square by under root of xz square. So under root of ac square, how can we write? Ac by under root of xz square, how can we write? Xz. Now you see, from this, take this as 1. From 1, AB by AC is equals to XY by XZ. Just if we return this as AB by this XY, I am taking here XY. This AC I am taking this side, AC by XZ. AB by XY is equal to AC by XZ. But here what we got? AC by XZ is equal to what? BC by YZ. So from these discussion, we can write that AB by XY is equal to AC by XZ is equal to BC by YZ. BC by YZ. We deserve one thing here. If the ratios of corresponding sides. Corresponding sides means this XY, this AB is one corresponding side. YZ and BC is one corresponding side. XZ and AC is one corresponding side. Like that. If the ratios of corresponding sides means AB by XY is equals to BC by YZ is equals to AC by XZ. The ratios of corresponding sides means AB by XY is equals to BC by YZ is equals to AC by XZ. If the ratios of corresponding sides of two triangles are equal, then the two triangles are said to be in, these two triangles are congruent to each other. The two triangles are congruent to each other, are similar to each other. Therefore, triangle ABC is similar to triangle XYZ. If these two triangles are similar to each other, then their corresponding sides are equal and corresponding angles also equal. If the corresponding sides are equal, then corresponding angles also equal. Means we can write angle A is equal to angle X. Here, is an earmark. This is somewhat of the difficult problem, whereas if you see in remaining problems, this concept, if you wanted to understand this concept, we should have learned the 8th chapter which we are having in our syllabus, 8th chapter, similar triangles. If we learn the similar triangles, then this thing, what we wrote, that will be very clear to you. But even though somewhat of this you can understand. Once again I will revise this. What he has given? ABC and XY are the two triangles he has given. We have drawn two triangles ABC and XYZ. Okay? Angle A and angle X are acute angles, he said. So angle A and angle X we have mentioned. These two are the acute angles we have taken. And in the given question, what he has given? Cos A is equal to cos X he has given. That is given. But we know what is cos A? Cos A is equal to AB by AC. By the definition. If you want, you can write in the bracket. By the definition. Now, AB by AC, then cos X is equal to what? XY by XZ. XY by XZ. But what we are doing? We are making this thing to K. We are assuming let AB by AC is equals to XY by XZ is equals to K we are taking. So from this, if AB by AC is equal to K, then AB is equal to what? K into AC. Like the same way, if XY by XZ is equals to K, then XY is equal to what? K into XZ. Now what we are doing means, we are taking the ratios of the sides BC and YZ. Ratios of the sides BC and YZ. So BC by YZ. BC by YZ. But using Pythagoras theorem, what we got? BC is equal to under root of AC square minus AB square. YZ is equal to under root of XZ square minus XY square. That only we have substituted here. BC is equal to under root of AC square minus AD square. YZ is equal to under root of XZ square minus XY square. This is equals to. But from this what we got? AB is equal to K into AC. XY is equal to K into XZ. These two values we have substituted in this. Instead of AB square we have substituted K into AC. Instead of XY square we have substituted K into XZ. So what we got? That is equal to under root of AC square minus K into AC whole square divided by under root of XZ square minus K into XZ whole square. Next step, what happened? AC square as it is minus K into AC whole square becomes K square into AC square divided by under root of XZ square as it is minus K into XZ whole square becomes K square into XZ square. That is equals to under root of. In these two we are having AC square common. That AC square I have taken common. We got 1 minus K square. In the denominator XZ square is common. That XZ square I have taken outside. XZ square is common means 1 minus K square. So in the numerator also we are having under root of 1 minus K square. In the denominator also under root of 1 minus K square is there. So, 1 minus k square and 1 minus k square got cancelled. Finally, what we got? Under root of a square minus under root of xz square. Root ac square is ac. Root xz square is xz. So, this thing we got now. For this, what we are doing? By taking this condition, ab by ac is equal to xy by xz. Ab by ac is equal to xy by XZ. What we are doing? We are transposing XY to LHS and AC to RHS. XY to LHS and AC to RHS. So AB by XY is equal to AC by XZ. But here AC by XZ is equal to BC by YZ. We got now?
Yes, sir.
From the solution, AC by XZ is equal to BC by YZ. We got. So from this side, this. From this side, this. What we wrote? AB by XY is equals to AC by XZ is equals to BC by YZ. Here one concept you have to remember, that when the ratios of the corresponding sides of two triangles, are equal, then the two triangles are said to be similar. Then the two triangles are said to be similar. If two triangles are similar, then their corresponding angles also equal. Their corresponding angles also equal. So triangle ABC is similar to triangle XYZ. Therefore, angle A is equal to angle X. So this is the sixth problem. And in your textbook, page number 280. Page number 280. One example problem is there. That is example 2. In page number 280 in your textbook, example 2 is similar to the sixth problem. Is similar to the sixth problem. Once you observe the sixth problem, example 2 in the page number 280 from the textbook. And the last problem in our exercise 11.1, you see, this thing I will give the hint you have to do. This thing I will give the hint you have to do. In a right angle triangle ABC, okay, let us take ABC is a right angle triangle. Right angle at B. Here it is right angle at B. If tan A is equal to root 3, he has considered tan A. Tan A is equal to root 3. Root 3 means the denominator is 1 now. What is the formula for tan? Opposite side by adjacent side. Here what is the opposite side? BC is the opposite side and adjacent side is AB. Means for the angle A, what is the opposite side? BC. BC is root 3. The adjacent side is AB. This is 1. You have to find AC. For finding AC using Pythagoras theorem. Using Pythagoras theorem, AC is equal to what? Under root of AB square plus BC square. Directly I am writing. AC is equal to under root of AB square plus BC square. That is equal to what? AB is what? 1 square plus BC is what? Root 3 whole square. So under root of 1 square is 1 plus under root of root 3 whole square is 3. It will be root 4. Root 4 is equal to how much?
2.
So this is 2. This is 2.
Yes, sir.
Here two questions in the given problem, two questions are there. Sin A cos C, cos A sin C. Cos A cos C, sin A sin C. First we will find sin A is equal to, for angle A, what is the opposite side? Opposite side by hypotenuse. That is BC by AC. What it is? Root 3 by 2. Like the same way, what is cos A? Cos A is adjacent side by hypotenuse. What is adjacent side here? AB by AC. AB is what? 1 by 2. Now in the given question, he has given C angle also. For angle C, what is the opposite side? AB. What is the adjacent side? BC. Therefore, sin C is equal to opposite side by hypotenuse. For C, what is the opposite side? AB. So AB by AC, this is 1 by 2. And cos C, adjacent side by hypotenuse. Here, BC by AC. That is equal to root 3 by 2. First question. Sin A cos C plus cos A sin C. So what is sin A here? Root 3 by 2 into cos C is what? Root 3 by 2 plus cos A is 1 by 2 into 1 by 2. Root 3 into root 3, 3 by 4 plus 1 into 1, 1 by 4. The denominators are same. We can add the numerators. 3 plus 1 by 4, that is equal to 4 by 4. 1. Second one, cos A cos C minus sin A sin C. What is cos A here? Cos A is 1 by 2 and cos C is root 3 by 2 minus sin A is root 3 by 2, sin C is 1 by 2. So this is root 3 by 4 minus root 3 by 4 will be 0. Once again I will explain. In a right angle triangle ABC, right angle B, tan A square root 3 given. We have taken ABC as a right angle triangle. We have considered the angle at A. So what is the tan deviation? Opposite side by adjacent side. So if denominator nothing is there, means by 1 we have taken. Opposite side by adjacent side, which is BC by AB. So BC is root 3, AB is 1. Using Pythagoras theorem, what we did? We have pointed the AC value. That AC value we got as 2. So in the given questions, sin A, opposite side by hypotenuse. For A, what is the opposite side? BC. Therefore BC by AC root 3 by 2. Like the same way we have pointed the remaining values. Just in the given question we have substituted the values, we got the answer. And by this problem our 11.1 exercise is completed. In the next class we will go through the 11.22. Right, thank you.